girl Nacho Nini, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a Taco Bell mukbang and a random talk. So I went to Taco Bell and I got the Nacho Party Pack, but I'm not going to be eating the whole thing. I actually divided it up with my grandma because I didn't want to eat the whole thing anyway, because I do love nachos, but I'm not that greedy. So this is what it looks like. This is my part of it. And I got the beef, and I did not get the jalapenos and guacamole because I don't like that. Even though I've never had guacamole, I don't want to try it. And jalapenos are too hot for me. So yeah, and I'm just going to be talking about some random stuff. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and get started with this video. To show you guys that I also have a drink. I guess I was so excited about the nachos I forgot about this, but I do have a strawberry freeze. I call it a slushy, but it's actually a freeze. So I forgot to mention that in my intro, but I do have a drink. So we finna just go ahead and jump right on in. Y'all, these nachos look so good. I wish you guys could see them, but I really wanted the camera to be on me and the nachos, and I didn't want to use my big tripod, so you guys will see me eating, but you won't be able to see the nachos. So yeah, so the first thing on my list for me to talk about is the fall season. I hate the fall. It's the worst season ever because I always get sick in the fall, whether it's October or November. I'm always getting sick. And so I get sick or have to miss days of school. And it's just not good. I just don't like the fall season. And also, since I do live down here in Tennessee, it gets cold really, really quickly in the fall. Because like as soon as fall hits, in October, no, in September, about the first or second week in October, it's already cold. Now this year it is a little different, because as soon as October hit, it got cold really, really fast. And personally, I kind of blame it on COVID, even though I don't think it's COVID's fault. It could be COVID's fault, but I blame it on COVID because I wasn't able to dress cute anymore for school for like the past 2 weeks. And so, I mean, I just don't like the fall season. Like, it's not one of my favorite seasons. I hate the fall. A lot of people love the fall, but I don't. It's the worst season ever. Halloween. I don't like Halloween either. Halloween is not a holiday. Even though some people think it is, but it's not. But I don't like Halloween. Like, I don't. I just don't. Now, when I was little, I used to love Halloween because I would dress up. Like, I was really excited about dressing up in costumes and going trick-or-treating around my neighborhood and getting candy. Oh, that's gonna blow away. Oh, well. But I used to dress up and get candy when I was smaller. And now, even though I am a teenager, I'm not really into dressing up in costumes anymore. But I still like the candy part of Halloween. That's probably the only reason why I still like Halloween. Even though you can get candy year round, but Halloween is really like the only time I really, well, no it's not. The only reason why I really like Halloween now is because of the candy. Because if it wasn't for the candy, I don't like Halloween. Presentation. I hate presentations. Like, really school presentations. Now, I know when I get into the real world and once I graduate, I'm gonna have to present. But I'm mainly talking about, like, school presentations when I have to get up in front of the whole class and present something. I kind of have a problem with that because I don't really like getting up talking in front of people, even though I have done like speeches at church before and I've gotten up and talked in front of them. But that's easier for me because I'm around people that I know, and I'm not scared. But far as school, the environment is different, the tension is different, everything is just different. And the most recent presentation I've done was actually last week. We had to do a joke presentation, and normally you have to memorize jokes. And so the day we were doing it, I had like a piece of paper so I could remember my joke. And so I let like 4 or 5, maybe 6 people go in front of me because I was nervous, and none of them had a piece of paper. They all memorized their joke. And so when I got up there, it was completely awkward for me because while the other people were going, I was trying to hurry up and memorize my joke. And I kind of did, even though I got up there and I kind of stumbled a little bit, but I still ended up remembering it. Because it was supposed to be like, I think 20 to 30 seconds. And so when I got up there, I had my hands crossed. I was trying to remember it. And I did remember it. I did end up saying my whole joke, but I kind of said it out of order because I was nervous. And so I just don't like presentations at all. Now, I don't have a problem with like presenting at my church or anything like that, because I know the people. I know they're all gonna applaud at the end because we're all a church family, we all love each other. But school presentations, it's just not good for me. I don't like them at all. Instrumental music. Now, I used to think instrumental music was dumb. There was no need for it, because what's the point of having an instrumental song without the lyrics? Like, instrumental music or songs, all it is just the beat and like the music. And at first I used to hate them because I was like, what's the point? Because I like to listen to songs with the lyrics in it, with the people talking in it, singing. And what's so ironic is the fact that I used to hate instrumental music and now I love it. That's so funny, right? I used to hate it, but now I love it. And I listen to so many instrumental songs now. It's crazy. Cartoons. I still watch cartoons at my age. It's kind of crazy that I do. Because I'm 17 and I still watch cartoons. I mean, I've been watching cartoons since I was a little girl. And now I still watch SpongeBob, Fairly Odd Parents, or Timmy Turner, The Amazing World of Gumball, Total Dramarama, Teen Titans Go. All these different cartoons out there, I still watch. And I need to break the habit, because I don't want to be watching cartoons when I'm like in my 20s and stuff. So I'm going to figure out how to break the habit of that, because I don't want to be older and still watching cartoons. I just don't. But I basically grew up on cartoons and I just love them. I mean, I feel like I'm still a kid. I still watch cartoons, all that good stuff. But I'm going to have to eventually break that habit. The thing that I'm eating right now, nachos. And honestly, I don't really even know how it came about being my favorite food, because I don't even remember when I first tried nachos, because I know it was a long time ago when I first tried nachos, but I just don't know how it became my favorite food. Like, I just don't. I mean, I've been eating nachos maybe since, maybe before I moved back down here. I think that's when I started liking nachos, because I used to live in Lebanon, Tennessee, and there was another city called Mount Juliet that was like 30 minutes away from where I lived. And so they had Cheddar's, they had Taco Bell, they had Chick-fil-A. Even though Chick-fil-A does not sell nachos, they had this stuff out there in Mount Juliet that Lebanon did not have. And the first time we went to Cheddar's in Mount Juliet, I think that's when I tried nachos. And then when we moved back down here, we discovered that there was a Cheddar's down here in Memphis. And so I went there, and when I first went to Cheddar's, I started getting like the kids menu, the chicken tenders, stuff like that. I didn't even know they had nachos until my mom was like, you need to try something new. You always eat the same stuff. So I decided to try the nachos, and back then they were called Ultimate Nachos, and they were super good. I mean, I really think that's how I started liking nachos, because of that. And then they changed it to Texas-sized nachos, and I was kind of upset, because last year in 2019, in January, when I turned 16 on a Sunday, we went to Cheddar's after church, and me not knowing at all that they changed their nachos to Texas-sized nachos. And so when I ordered that, it came back, and it had like barbecue sauce on it, it had corn, it had all this other stuff nachos shouldn't even have. And so I was pretty upset, because I was like, well, my 16th birthday dinner is ruined, because who puts corn and barbecue sauce on nachos? Like, who does that? That's nasty. And so I did eat some of it, but I didn't eat it all, because it just didn't taste right. It didn't taste right to me. And now they don't have nachos at all at Cheddar's, and I'm so mad, because their nachos were good. And so I really hope they bring them back, because their nachos were the bomb. And so now I'm gonna be getting my nachos from Taco Bell from now on, because these right here are really, really good. So actually, they did have the Grande Nacho box at Taco Bell, and the first time I tried it, I was like, oh my gosh, this is so good. And so I was like, I have to come back here again on fall break and get this so I can do a video. And so one day after school, on Monday or Wednesday, I don't remember which day it was, I think it was on a Monday, I came from school and I went to Taco Bell to get the Nacho Grande box, and they said, I'm sorry, we're out of chips. And I'm like, how you gonna be a Mexican restaurant that sells nachos and you're out of chips? How you gonna be out of chips? Like, come on now, how you gonna be out of chips? And so I was pretty miserable afterwards, because it was a pretty day, I was dressed pretty, and I wanted to do that video, but I couldn't because they didn't have chips. And so then they came out with the Nachos Party Pack, and I was thinking, okay, I'm gonna have to get that and do my video off of that. And so this is what we're doing today. YouTube lately has been messing with me with the comments, because they were telling me that my comments were turned off because of kids' safety reasons. They didn't want kids to be exposed to something that they don't want them seeing. And I was like, well, there is nothing inappropriate on my channel. And so last week I uploaded a small YouTube support video, and y'all probably know I had to delete that video about 3-4 times and upload it again because they were messing with me in my comments. And at one point they were turned back on. Check again, they were turned off. And it was just going back and forth. And I was like, there's nothing wrong with this. I mean, all it is just like a minute long video trying to help people out there grow their channel. And they over here turning off my comments. For what though? I mean, seriously. And so now I have to the point where they don't turn my comments off anymore. Hopefully they won't. But they need to take a chill pill, because everything on my channel is appropriate. There is nothing on my channel that's inappropriate, so they need to learn their lesson and never turn my comments off again, because I make great videos. So they need to learn their lesson. So a funny fact about me, this is really ironic, like this really hit me about a few months ago. So I'm born in the winter season, right? Winter baby, January 20th, Aquarius season, Aquarius queen, whatever. Born in the coldest month of the winter season. And I'm hot natured. I'm always hot. I always feel like I have to have air on. And all the birds that's going by. Wow. But I always have to have on the air or the fan, because I'm always hot. I'm constantly hot. And so I just thought how weird that was, because I was born in the winter season and I'm hot natured. Like, that is really funny and ironic to me. It's just really weird to me why that is what it is. But you can't change when we're born. Subjects in school. I hate math. I do not like math at all. It's my least favorite subject. Now, I used to like math when I was in elementary and middle school. I am so sorry for the interruption. My mom had to bring the dog outside and she was being bad. But anyway, back to what I was talking about. Math is not my favorite subject in school anymore. I used to like math, but I don't like it anymore. But when I was in elementary school and middle school, I used to love math. Because back then, it was super easy. Now we have algebra, pre-cal, statistics, calculus, trigonometry, like all this stuff that we don't need. I mean, even though we do need algebra 1, geometry, algebra 2, and pre-cal to graduate high school, we need that stuff. Personally, I'm not going to be a math teacher or any teacher when I'm older, when I graduate from college. I'm not going to be a teacher. I mean, what's the point in knowing all this number stuff? Like, there's no point in that. My favorite subjects is history and science, but history is my favorite. Like, I love history. Because it's so factual, and you learn stuff off of history. You don't really learn anything with math, especially now during COVID season. Not learning anything. And so history is just fun, it's easy, it's factual. We get to learn about the history in the United States, in the world, all that good stuff. And science actually used to not be my favorite as well. Or actually, when I was in elementary school and middle, I hated science with a passion. Like, I could not, because science has numbers in it too. You have to calculate like velocity and density and stuff like that. I used to hate that stuff. And when I got into high school, I took physical science 9th grade. I took biology 10th grade and chemistry in 11th grade. And I loved it. I mean, I think my two favorites in high school was biology and chemistry. But I really love science. Science is definitely my second favorite subject. The worst thing about being a YouTuber, in my ideal, will have to be re-recording or re-editing a video. I've only done this maybe a few times, like record a video, like re-record a video. I never really had to re-edit a video. Probably the only time I had to re-edit a video was last year, when my channel was like not really up and running then, but my channel was actually going somewhere. Oh goodness. And I had to re-edit a video. But honestly, re-recording a video is worse than re-editing a video. Because personally, I like to have my stuff together. I just don't put anything together and just upload it and make myself look crazy. Because we not gonna do that over here. But re-recording a video takes a lot of work because you already did it before. And obviously you didn't like it. So there's something you have to change about that. Now, I don't re-record a lot of my videos. Like after I record my intro, I go look at that to make sure it's okay. If my video was not too long, I will go back and look at that after I record it. And then same thing with my outro, because I want my stuff to be perfect when I'm uploading it to the internet. I don't want it to be anything and just put it together and I'm looking crazy. Like, we're not finna do that. So if we have to redo something on Natural Nini's channel, we're gonna redo it. High school. I don't remember what I even wanted to talk about with high school. Oh, yes, I do. So high school so far, at least from freshman up to my junior year, it's been pretty okay. Even though I completely hated my freshman year, like, I didn't like anything at all about my freshman year, except for my wellness teacher. That was the only teacher in the whole entire school that I liked. I didn't like anybody else, especially my English teacher. My English teacher, freshman year, was the worst. She was a complete worst. Like, I hated her so much, because she made us do our quizzes and tests in pen, because if we ended up getting something wrong, we wouldn't be able to erase it. And I thought that was kind of dumb, because like, why would we want to do our stuff in pen? That's so dumb. I hated her the most though in 9th grade. 10th grade, sophomore year, that has been my favorite year of high school so far. I love sophomore year. I mean, everything about sophomore year was perfect. Everything. Junior year was pretty okay. some teachers I did not like junior year was my English teacher again. My English teacher last year when I was a junior was actually worse than my English teacher freshman year, because she made us do all of our work in pen. Every single thing we had to do in pen. We even had to write an outline for an essay in pen. I'm like, she's worse than my English teacher in ninth grade. I mean, she over here making us do our work in pen. And then when we take quizzes and tests, we did that in pencil. And I was like, okay, these two must know each other, because they must know each other, they must be related or something. Because I did not like that at all. I did not. And then on top of that, it either had to be done in blue ink or black ink. Couldn't be done in red ink. It couldn't be done in any other color ink, because she grades with different colors. So I was like, that's just so stupid. Like, that was ridiculous to me. And another teacher I did not like my junior year was my Spanish teacher. He was the worst. Like, I did not like him at all. Like, at all. Because if folks were to act up in his class, or like talk while he's talking, or disrupting, or talking across the rows, just like baseball, strike one, you're out, strike two, you're out, strike three, everybody in the classroom gets punished. We would have to either do extra work and turn it in before the end of the class period, or we would have homework that's like 2-3 pages long, and we would have to have it done and turn it in the next day. And if it wasn't, we would get a big fat zero. And that was for everybody in the class, when only 2 or 3 people messed up in class. I just thought that was really stupid. Because what's the point of you punishing the whole class just because of 2-3 people? Like, that's not fair. You shouldn't be punishing the whole class just because of 2 or 3 people. And senior year right now, you're not supposed to like your senior year. Right now, I hate my senior year. I hate it right now. Like, it's the complete worst. It is the complete worst because of COVID. Because we go to school, or at least I do anyway, we go to school 2 days a week. I'm at home the other 3 days of the week doing work that I really don't understand. Because the teacher's not teaching us anything. We're not learning anything. Everybody is just basically self-teaching now, because teachers not doing their jobs. And so, senior year right now, it's a complete worst. It is a complete worst. Honestly, I wish I was either a freshman, sophomore, or junior this year. Because if I was a junior, I would have one more year before high school. It's over with. If I was a sophomore, 2 more years. If I was a freshman, 3 more years. Because senior year, it's just not going well right now for me. Like, it's not. It's the complete worst. Rain. I hate the rain. Some people love the rain. I don't see how people love the rain. Because when it rains, it's like twice as cold. It's windy. And if it's windy and raining, that's the worst. Heavy rain is the complete worst. Like, I don't like rain at all. I just don't. It's just so dreary outside. And it's just boring inside. And especially if you have to be stuck inside your house with nothing to do while it's raining outside. Like, that whole day is just boring. And so down here in Tennessee, unless something changes, it's gonna rain this whole entire weekend. And I'm just not here for it. I'm just not. Like, I don't like the rain. I completely hate it. Honestly, I don't see how people like the rain. I mean, they're just weird, dark, and gloomy. Because, no. I like sunshine and snow. I don't like the rain. I don't do rain. None of that. The bus. I'm so glad this year that I don't have to ride the bus. Because I actually started riding the bus. I think when I was in 8th grade, that's when I first started riding the bus. And I hated it since then. And I think the worst year for the bus, I think it was last year when I was a junior. And no, take it back. Well, actually, sophomore and junior year were the worst years of me riding the bus. The kids on the bus were so disrespectful towards the bus driver. They had no type of home training. They just do whatever they want on the bus. They tell the bus driver to shut up and do her job. And it was just so awkward and weird and uncomfortable. I mean, I hated it. And I'm so glad this year I don't have to ride the bus, because I got my license in July and I can start driving to school. And I'm really happy about that, because I mean, even if it was or wasn't COVID season right now in 2020, I probably still would have been driving myself to school, because I got my permit last year and I got my license this year, so I still would have been driving to school even if it wasn't COVID season. But since it is COVID season, my mom does not want me to get on the bus. And so since I only go to school for 2 days, on Mondays and Wednesdays, she comes and picks me up. And so I actually think I'm going to be driving to school probably sometime this semester before the end of the year. I really hope so, because I want to drive to school. But yeah, so I'm really glad that I don't ride the bus anymore, because being on the bus with disrespectful, non-disciplined kids is the complete worst. I hate being in silence. Like, that might be a pet peeve. I don't like being in silence. Like, if it's at nighttime, and let's say it's past midnight, and the TV were to conk out, or not conk out, but like go out, and it's just complete silence, I can't do it. I would either have to play a game and turn the volume up, or play music and turn the volume up, or something, or like play a video. I just can't be in silence. I guess it's a pet peeve, I don't really know. I just can't be in silence. Like, I don't like silence. I have to have some type of noise going on. I just have to. Like, I can't stand the silence. And another thing, I also can't stand the dark either. I've been sleeping with the nightlight ever since I was a little girl. Probably before I even reached double digits, I was sleeping with a nightlight. And at the age I am now, I still sleep with the nightlight. And I just don't like the dark. I hate silence and I hate the dark. So I'm gonna have to get out of the dark though, because I don't want to grow up and then I meet somebody, and then we start a family, we live in a house, and then it's pitch black dark and I have nightlight burning. He probably gonna think I'm crazy, cause like, you're a grown woman and you can't sleep in the dark. So I'm gonna have to find some way to force myself out of that, because I do not want to do that when I get older. So I'm gonna have to figure out something. But for right now, while I'm still living in my mama's house, we sleeping with the nightlight on. Roller coasters. I hate roller coasters. Now, I love going to amusement parks and the fair, stuff like that, but I don't get on nobody's roller coaster. I don't. Well, I actually got on roller coaster once. I think it was when I was in Disney World about a few years ago. I think in 2014, I got on a roller coaster or some type of ride that was like a roller coaster, and I had a hat, and I lost it because it fell off while I was on the roller coaster. And so, I think ever since then, I was afraid of being on a roller coaster. Because since I do wear glasses, I would be afraid that my glasses will fall off and break and I wouldn't be able to find them. And I would be blind as a bat until I could buy me some more. And so, I just don't like roller coasters. I don't. They're scary. They're fun to watch, but they're not fun to be on. And I've only been on one in my whole entire life. And I'm never getting back on one because I don't do roller coasters. Mm-mm. Scary movies. I don't like scary movies. This goes along with Halloween or any time of the year, but mainly Halloween. I don't watch scary movies. Now, I won't really call it a scary movie, but my favorite, all-time favorite movies is Boo 2 is Madea Halloween and Boo is Madea Halloween. Those two movies are the only ones I consider scary that I can watch and not have nightmares off of, because Madea is crazy. She's had all kind of other movies out that were super duper funny, and those are the only kind of movies I would watch during Halloween time and not be scared of. Like, I don't do horror movies, scary movies, movies that will have you traumatized for the rest of your life. Mm-mm. Don't do it. Too scary. Don't do it. Now, I have heard of scary movies like Chucky and Annabelle, but personally, I would never watch it. I would never watch it. And I hope my husband or my future soulmate I meet does not like scary movies, because if he does, we gonna have a problem. Okay, Houston, we have a problem, because I don't do scary movies. I don't do that. People jumping out at you. They're about making you pee on yourself. No. Mm-mm. We not doing that. Ghosts, goblins, stuff like that. All that stuff that got to do with Halloween, scary movies, we not doing it. So I hope he doesn't like scary movies, because we gonna have a problem. So here's a fun little topic. Vlogmas. I really want to do a Vlogmas this year, but I don't really know about uploading a video every single day until December 25th. I don't know about that, because even though I do have video ideas, I don't think I would have one for like every single day for 24 days. Well, technically 25, because you still have to upload on Vlogmas day 25. I mean, I might do a Vlogmas, but it's probably going to be like a shortened version of Vlogmas. I probably won't upload every single day till Christmas. Now, I'll probably upload on Christmas Day, but I probably won't upload every single day until Christmas, because that's just too much. Getting scared. I would have to say, I don't get scared of every single little thing, but I do get scared. I get scared sometimes. Like, if you're somewhere by yourself, well, if I'm in my house by myself somewhere, or if I'm talking to my mom or my grandma, and then all of a sudden, one of them will pop up out of the blue, and I will literally scream and jump. Because I would be scared, because like, I didn't know it was coming. And so, you know, it's just stuff like that that kind of catches you off guard, and you don't know what's happening until it happens. And because when it happens, I'll be like, whoa, you scared me. Like, where in the world you just come from? It's stuff like that that just kind of does something to you. And I would have to say that's the only thing I would really get scared of. I really don't get scared of anything else, honestly. But that's pretty much it for that. vacation. I really wish I was on a vacation right now. Y'all, I'm about to run out of my juice. It was so good. I wish I got a large. But I really wish I was on vacation right now. Probably because of school. School right now is really intimidating me to go on vacation. But I can't because of COVID. Because I'm not going to travel on a plane to another state where cases are rising. And so my mom and I were actually planning a trip to I think Tampa or Miami, Florida, for fall break. What was it? I think Memorial Day weekend. We were planning a trip to one of those two cities in Florida, and because of COVID, we weren't able to do that. And so that just kind of really put my dreams, well, not my dreams, but like vacation down the drain, because I was really looking forward to it, because we were already talking about it in January this year, and then COVID hit and just ruined all of 2020's plans. Like, it really did. So vacation issue is out. Because my mom and I really don't travel that much in the year. Because if we do, it would either be in the summertime or 4th of July holiday or Memorial Day, and that's pretty much it. So, thanks to COVID, that just ruined those vacation plans. And last but not least, what I'm going to be talking about, probably going to be pretty weird. But Barbie. So when I was a little girl, I was playing with Barbie dolls like all the time. Like, I had Barbie dolls, Bratz dolls, Liv dolls. I'll put a picture on the screen if you guys don't know what that is. But when I was a little girl, I used to love playing with dolls. And so I've always wanted the Barbie dream house when I was a little girl, but it cost so much. Like, back then I think it was cheaper. I think it was like $50, but now it's way worse. And obviously I wouldn't get it now because I'm 17 and I honestly wouldn't have anything to do with it because I don't have any little sisters. So I wouldn't be able to do anything with it. And you know what's so funny? I actually really still want the Barbie dream house. Like, I really do. Because I saw it on TV recently. And I was like, wow, I've wanted that ever since I was a little girl. Oh, y'all, I got choked for a minute. Trust me, I do not have COVID. I was choking. But anyway, back to what I was talking about. I saw it on TV recently and I wanted it. But it would be kind of weird for a 17-year-old playing with the Barbie dollhouse. So I just kind of left it where that was. But I really wish I did play with, or at least get that house when I was little, because I've always wanted to play with it. But sometimes all of our childhood dreams don't come true. So it is what it is. And I think that's pretty much it. That's all I really have down, written down here on my list. I don't really have that many nachos left, other than like these chips. Oh man, a piece of my meat just fell off. Man, that was about to be so good. I bet you want that, huh, Peaches? Y'all, I'm so sad. My meat really just fell off. I was about to eat it too. I can't even get this open. But anyway, I think that's pretty much it. I don't really have that much meat left. I don't have any meat left at all. So I probably either end up throwing this away or eating the rest of the chips. But that's pretty much it for this video. How long this video was gonna be, because the first time I started recording and when I stopped it, when I got interrupted, it was over 17 minutes long, and the second segment is 26 minutes. So I kind of feel like this video is either gonna be at 50 minutes or an hour. I don't know, I'm just scared to find out. But I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, because I already know it's gonna be super duper long. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and share my channel, and help me reach my goal of 850 subscribers. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.